Good morning. I'm going to present an abstract of the results I've got during the thesis I've made 2 years ago at the Institut National du Patrimoine in Paris. It focused on the study and the conservation project of a drawing album from the Musée Condé de Chantilly. This album was composed in 1840 by the French painter Félix Philippoteau. The drawings had been first designed on sketch boots during a 4-month journey of the artist in Algeria, where he had followed the French army during a military campaign. The drawing depicts scenes from the military life, from the life of military camps, the local population, some animals, and portraits of French soldiers. The album contains drawings made with graphite, watercolor, and black ink. They are pasted by 4 dots of animal glue in the corners. They were mostly in good condition, but the adhesive dots in the corners created tensions and some brown stains. The album pages paper was yellowed and had many foxing stains. The edges and the pages were torn and mechanically weak. They were mostly already detached from the binding. First, it appears as the necessity to eliminate the tensions and the animal glue on the drawings. This operation required to take off each paper individually and to reattach it with an adhesive suitable for paper conservation. This removal allowed us to proceed to the paper washing of the pages while preserving the drawings of moisture exposure. The aim of the treatments of the pages was to consolidate them mechanically and to water clean them. Thereby, the drawings would have better conditions of aging and the foxing stains would be mitigated. The water cleaning aimed to extract the soluble degradation products formed by hydrolysis or oxidations to stabilize chemically the paper. The common washing method presents some drawbacks that we wanted to avoid. Thus, with the help of the scientists from the chemistry lab of the National Library of France, Émilie Lebourg and Stéphane Bouvet, we have developed a series of experiments in order to find the best way to perform the paper washing of the album pages. We conducted a comparative study of 3 cleaning methods. To start our study, we identified the characteristics of the paper and to perform the cleaning test, we found a paper with very similar characteristics regarding the composition, thickness, pH, and sizing. The first cleaning method consists in a simple immersion wash in a purified water bath, stirring and changing the water regularly to revive compound's diffusion movement. The second method involved the use of paraprint. The paraprint OL60 is a non-woven material. It can be used in different ways. The first is to achieve a capillary unit. A strip of paraprint is placed on an inclined plexiglass plane. One of its ends is placed in a container with purified water. The other end hangs above an empty container placed below, the filled container that collects water with the degradation products after cleaning. The paper to be treated is placed directly on the band of paraprint. By capillarity, a flow is created and the water passes through the paraprint sheet from the reservoir to the other end, carrying with it the soluble products present in the paper. The second possibility to use the paraprint for the paper cleaning is to use it in the same way as for treatment with damp blotters. Finally, the third method tested in my research involved rigid gels. A gel piece cut to size and shape wanted is applied directly on above or underneath the paper. It releases slowly and evenly thanks to its retention power, water molecules that penetrate the paper and dissolve the degradation compounds. These are then attracted into the gel by diffusion and capillary action. Following preliminary tests with agar gels, agarose, and gel and gum, and reading of literature, we choose to compare gel and gum and agar. We use 3 different gel concentrations, 2, 3, and 4%. We put the slabs above the paper, then a piece of Mellinex and a lightweight. Here is a table summarizing the chosen methods and processing times. They were determined after preliminary testing. Immediately after treatment, we conduct a weighting of the samples in order to check the weight gain corresponding to the introduction of water into the paper. The results were as follows. We found that the release of water is faster with agar than with gel and gum, for which it is more progressive, and in both cases it stabilizes after an hour of treatment. We have therefore chosen for further tests to focus on gel and gum. In the case of immersion and paraprint, the weight gain is equivalent regardless of the processing time. It is very fast and then remains stable. Our conclusions after those tests are that samples treated with paraprint have absorbed a much greater amount of water than other treatments. With all treatments by gels, even after a long time, the paper had absorbed less water than after a short immersion. Then, a second very simple test with a drop of water was performed on samples to assess the porosity of the paper in order to check a possible loss of sizing. The paper was very sized before treatment. If we applied a drop of water on the surface, it did not penetrate without applying a pressure, and the drop could stay for hours. After treatment, we found a very strange phenomenon. For the samples treated by immersion or with gels, no change could be seen. The drop behaved exactly the same way as before. On the other hand, with all the samples treated with paraprint, the drop had a very different behavior. It penetrated into the paper in a few seconds. The paper seems to have lost its sizing, or at least it has been very much reduced. For now, the explanation of this phenomenon are still at the stage of hypothesis, and the research are still ongoing. Thus, it seems clear that the paraprint causes a significant loss of sizing on the paper studied. This loss is also responsible of the high water penetration observed by taking the mass. The paper has become completely porous and waterlogged. The principle of precaution imposed us not to use this type of treatment for the pages paper of the album. The choice of treatment has thus to be made between immersion and gel and gum. To compare them, we decided to conduct pH testing, colorimetry, and mechanical testings. The result of the pH tests revealed that all treatments resulted in an equivalent increase of the pH between 0.5 and 1 point. The colorimetric test allowed us to compare the extraction power of colored compounds, which are part of the degradation products in the paper. We measured the color range. The results allowed showed that the paper treated with gelan do not have a color change equivalent between the side that is in direct contact with the gel and the other side. However, the change is greater than that obtained with an immersion on the side in contact with the gel and equivalent on the other side. At this point of the study, gel and gum seemed to be a good option to treat our paper. We also carried out mechanical testing on other samples. It is common to hear that a cross-treatment causes an increase of paper strains. However, some others contradict this assertion and relate that in some cases they can also reduce it. This is why we decided to check out paper strengths with a dynamometer. Half of the samples were tested right after treatment and half of them after an accelerated aging. This diagram represents the value of the strength in Newton that was applied to the sample of paper when it was broken. We can observe on it that all treatments bring an immediate increase of the tensile strength in the paper. This value is reduced after aging, but less with gel and gum. As a conclusion, I can say that this study has enabled me to choose a cleaning method suitable for the album pages. Our experiments permit to exclude the use of paraprint, which important amount of water intake and loss of sizing were too invasive for the paper. In contrast, the use of gel and gum seemed to present many advantages. The amount of water intake is lower than with immersion and more progressive than the fibers swell less and in a less brutal way. Also, its implementation requires less manipulation of the paper, which is particularly appreciable with weak and damaged papers. It allows a permanent control and a possibility to interrupt easily the treatment if necessary, in contrary of a treatment by immersion. Furthermore, the degradation products are extracted in a vertical and homogeneous way without a prior diffusion in the paper. We preceded the treatment at 3% concentration with the slab underneath the paper and during 2 hours. The visual results were very satisfying on the album pages. This research has enabled me to realize the most suitable treatment for the album of Chantilly's museum, even if it's not exhaustive due to the short time we had to do it. I have to precise that all the results presented here are right only for one precise type of paper and a specific implementation, and we would probably have found different behavior with other types. Thank you for your attention.